Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Varmai and welcome to the second part of Chapter 6 Morphological Image Processing. In the previous video, we have seen two basic morphological operations, that is dilation and erosion. Now moving further, let's see the third operation, that is called as opening. The symbol of opening is a small circle, okay, it's a hollow circle, and the opening of A by stretching element B is defined as A erode B, the whole, then dilated by B. So it's a cascade of operations that we do. So first what we do is we erode A by B, and whatever result, we then dilate it again by structuring element B. And this whole operation we call it as opening. So if you consider the geometric representation, it is nothing but rolling the structuring element B inside the boundary of A. Okay, it is also defined as union of all BZ such that BZ belongs to A. For understanding, consider this example over here. So we have a triangular object A, and the structuring element B is a circular disc, and its center is its origin. So if we do this operation, that means we first erode and then we dilate it, then whatever result we are going to get, it can be obtained directly if we roll the structuring element B inside the boundary of A. So in this figure, first figure, you can see that the circular disc, that is structuring element, is rolled over here and different positions are shown. Okay, it can touch inside the boundary, it cannot go outside. In the second image, one can see the path traced by rolling this structuring element. So when you do the opening operation, what you will see is the shape that is shown with a gray color in the third image. So you can see that the three corners of A are actually removed when you have done this opening operation. The main applications of opening involve smoothing of contours, breaking the narrow necks, or eliminating thin overhangs. So smoothing of contour we have already seen in the previous example. Let's see the other two applications in the next example. Now consider an object A that is shown in the figure, and we have a structuring element B, which is again a circular disc. Now in this case, if you see the diameter of the disc, and if you see there is a small neck in A, okay, so there are two parts in A, one is on the left side and other is on the right hand side, and there is a small neck in between it. The width of that neck is actually less than the diameter of structuring element B. Similarly, there are two overhangs on the left side as well as two overhangs on the right hand side. However, the overhangs on the left side are having a width greater than the diameter of B, whereas on the right side the two overhangs that we have a width less than the diameter of B. So now what we are going to do, we are going to process it and we are going to perform the operation of opening. So first what we are going to do is we are going to perform the operation of erosion, and whatever result we get, then we are going to perform the operation of dilation. So let's perform the operation of erosion on this element A by structuring element B. So as we know, when we do the operation of erosion, the structuring element B should be totally contained inside the object A. Okay, then only we will have a valid result, otherwise the result will be zero. So when you perform this, okay, the structuring element B can fit in the neck of, sorry, overhangs of left hand side, so it will give some results. However, when you try to fit it on the right hand side overhangs, it will not fit it, okay, because it cannot be totally contained inside A. The width over there is smaller compared to the diameter of B. Same thing will also happen with the neck, okay. The neck cannot be totally containing structuring element B because its width is less than the diameter of B. Hence, when you perform the erode operation, your structuring element is going to shrink, your object A by radius that is half the diameter on each side. Okay, and while doing this, you can see the result. Okay, that is shown in the fourth figure over here. That is A erode B. Okay, you can clearly see that the neck has been removed and the two overhangs on the right hand side are also removed, whereas the two overhangs on the left hand side has now become thin. Now whatever result we have, okay, for that result now we are going to perform the operation of dilation. Now when we dilate, what we are going to do is we are looking for overlap of A and B cap, where B cap is a reflected version of B. Now in this case B is a circular disc, hence its reflected version will be same as that of B. Okay, so when you try to find the overlap, which is shown in the fifth figure over here, okay, it will try to expand the image. Again, the expansion will be by amount of the radius of that circular disc on each side, and finally you will get the result of the opening. Now when you observe this opening result, what you will see, okay, most of the parts have the same thickness or the width that of the original element of A. However, the contours, you can see that the corners, okay, are now smooth, which were initially tapered. Also, the neck between the two parts of A is removed totally, and the overhang is also removed, which was present on the right hand side. Now, there are certain properties of opening that one should remember. Now, the first property is A opening with B is a subset, or we can say sub-image of A. Okay, that means the operation of opening is subset of its input. Also, if we have C subset of D, then C open with B is a subset of D open with B. So there is a kind of a monotonicity that will be preserved when you perform this operation of opening. And third property is related to recursion. Okay, it says that A opening with B, and whatever result we have, if we again open with B, then we will get the same result as that of A opening with B. That means if you apply more than one opening operation, that means if you recursively do this operation, then there is no effect on the result. Okay, so you can do opening operation only once. After that, if you again do the opening operation again and again, there is no change in the result. Now let's move to the fourth morphological operation, that is called as closing. Actually, when you consider closing, it is kind of opposite of opening. So closing operation, mathematically or symbol, when you denote, it is a filled circle or a solid circle that we use. So closing of A by structuring element B is, first we do A dilate with B, and whatever result we erode with B. So it is again a cascade of operation. Okay, only thing is this time the order is opposite of that of opening. In opening we have first done the erosion and then the dilation. In the closing we will first do the dilation and then we will do the operation of erosion. So if you consider the geometric interpretation, in this particular case you will be rolling the structuring element B outside the boundary of A. Okay, in the previous case, that is in case of opening, we have rolled it inside the boundary of A. This time we will be rolling it outside the boundary of A. Let's consider this example to understand this closing operation. So over here we have element A, and you can see that element A has a V-shaped valley in it, and again we are considering a structuring element B, which is a circular disc. So if we roll structuring element B outside the boundary of A, then the path traced is shown in second figure, and the final output will be whatever inside this particular path. So that is what is shown in the third figure. The applications of closing involve fusion of narrow breaks or long thin gulfs. It can also eliminate small holes, or it can fill the gaps in the contours. So to understand this, let's see the next example. Consider the same example again. So we have the element A as shown in the figure, and structure element B, which is again a disc. And as we already seen, there were two overhangs on the left hand side as well as right hand side. So there is a thin gulf that is formed on the left hand side. And of course, so we have a overhang on the right hand side of A. Okay. Now when we perform the operation of closing, first we are going to dilate it and then we are going to erode it. So when we dilate A with structuring element B, now here for B again we require B cap, but if you observe, since A is a circular disc, the B cap will be same as B. So when you perform the operation of dilation, the A will expand by the radius of B cap, or you can say the radius of B on each side. So when it expands, okay, that is what is shown in the third figure over here. So when it expands, you can see that the gulf which was present on the left hand side is now totally filled in. Okay. Also, when you do this, the neck has become thicker now, and the overhangs have also become thicker on the right hand side. So that is what the final result of A dilate with B look like, which is shown in figure 4 over here. Now whatever this result we have, we are now going to perform the operation of erosion. So when we perform the operation of erosion, now we are going to use B, okay, and then we are going to shrink this result by the radius of B on each side. So when you shrink it, okay, it is shown in the how it is done, it is shown in fifth figure, and the final result is shown in the sixth figure. So when you see the final result, you can clearly see that it is kind of restoring the size or the shape of the object back. However, in that case, whatever the gulf which was present on the left hand side is now filled. And also, if you see the edges, okay, which were inside the object, okay, these edges have now become smooth. Okay, in the previous case, when we have done the operation of closing, the edges on the outside were becoming smooth. Over here, the edges which were inside the image are now becoming smooth. Now in this case, if you see the properties, then you will find that the element A is a subset of A closed with B, or we can say the input is actually the subset of the output that we get by closing operation. This is mainly because we are rolling the structuring element outside the boundary of A. Okay, also there is a monotonicity that is preserved when you perform the operation of closing. So if you have C subset of D, then C closed by B is a subset of D closed by B. Okay, and also there is a recursion property. So if you recursively apply the closing operation, that means A closed with B, whatever the result, if you close with B, it will be same as A closed with B. That means if you recursively apply the closing operation, again there is no change, similar to what you get in your opening operation. So if you see the operation of opening and closing, okay, one can see that they are complementing each other. In fact, they have a very good relationship. That means opening and closing operation are dual of each other with respect to set complementation and reflection. It is somewhat similar to what we have in case of dilation and erosion. Okay, so if you perform A closed with B, and then if you take the complement of the result, that result will be same as A complement opened with B cap. Okay, so it is a kind of a similar relationship that you have when it comes to the opening closing operation. So this operation of opening and closing, actually they look very simple, but they are very powerful operation when it comes to the image processing. So to understand this, let's consider this simple example. So over here we are performing an operation called as morphological filtering, or also called as morphological noise removal, using opening and closing operation. So in this case, the idea is very simple. What you do is you have a binary noisy image, and you first open that image with a particular structuring element, and then whatever the result, you close it. So it is a kind of a cascade operation of opening closing, and we have already seen that opening and closing themselves are the cascade operations of dilation and erosion. Okay, so step by step we will see the results. Okay, In this particular slide, you can see the overall operation, what is done. So overall, first what we have is image A. Okay, so we are performing an operation of opening first. Okay, so when we open, actually we will first perform the operation of erosion, which will then followed by an operation of dilation. So that will complete the opening operation, and after that we will perform the operation of closing. So in closing, we'll first perform the operation of dilation and then the operation of erosion. And in this case, for this particular application, actually we have used a structuring element that is a 3x3 structuring element with all ones. To understand clearly, now let's see the zoomed versions of these results. So first we have the image A, and we have a structuring element B. So A over here is a fingerprint image, and it's a binary image. Now in this image, you can clearly see that the background, which is black, has some noisy pixels. Also, the fingerprint information, which is in terms of ridges over here, also has some noise. Okay, so in between the ridges also, you can see some white dots, and on the ridges, which are white, we can see some black dots. Okay, so if we use this fingerprint directly, then we might get some false results. So what we do is, we first remove the noise from this fingerprint using morphological operation. So for that, we are using a structuring element B, which is a 3x3 element as shown in the figure over here. And as I said, we are going to first perform the operation of opening and then the operation of closing. Now in this case, we have assumed that the noise what is present, okay, that is less than 2 pixel thick. That's why we have selected the structuring element as 3 pixel thick. Okay, now let's perform the operation of opening first. So in opening, first we are going to perform erosion and then dilation. So first we are going to erode A with B. So for erosion, we need that the structuring element should lie totally inside the object. Okay, so the noisy pixels, if they are less than the 3x3 thickness, then it will never be containing the structuring element B, and hence the result will be zero. So if you see the result of overall operation, you can see that the background noise, which was present initially in A, after erosion is removed. Also the ridges, okay, which were initially thick, now has become thin because of the operation of thinning, because of the operation of erosion, because we know that the erosion is going to shrink the objects. The operation of erosion actually has helped us to remove the background noise. Okay, however, at the same point, you can see that there are two problems that it has created. The first is, it has thinned the ridges. Okay, so original thickness of the ridges has now reduced. And the second problem is, there are some breaks that are created in the ridges. Of course, there were some breaks already present in the ridges in the original image. These breaks have now become wider. At the same time, there are some new breaks that are created by this operation of erosion. Now, when you perform the second step of opening, that is the dilation. Now, dilation is going to expand the object. So, when you perform it on the result of erosion, it will again restore the thickness of the ridges. Okay, so the ridges will again expand back. So, whatever the unnecessary gaps that were created, okay, they will be filled back by this operation of dilation. However, the gaps which are already present in the original image, they will still remain as it is. Okay, but the thing is, now in this particular case, when we are completed the operation of opening, there is no background noise that is present. To fill back the breaks that are present in the ridges, now we perform the operation of closing. So whatever opening result we have, on that we are going to perform the operation of closing. So the first step of the closing is dilation. Okay, so we are going to take the output of the opening and we are going to dilate it again by structuring element B. So now when we dilate it, okay, it will expand the ridges more. So this expansion will now fill those breaks which are present in the ridges. At the same time, now the thickness of the ridges will be much more than the original thickness. And to reset it back, we are going to perform the operation of erosion. So that is going to complete the closing operation. So now finally, when we perform the operation of erosion, then what it is going to do is shrink the thickness back. But what has happened is already when we have done the operation of opening, and then when we have done the operation of dilation, whatever the gaps which were present, now they have been filled back. So my ridges are now continuous. And when I perform the operation of erosion now, the thickness of the ridges will be brought back to the original thickness. And that is how we will get this final result, which is now totally noise free. Also, whichever small gaps or breaks which were present in the ridges, they are now filled back. And now we can use this fingerprint for further operation like identification or verification of a person. Before we end this video, let me pose a challenging problem for you. You can write the answer along with your roll number and name and mail the answer to me at ivpashish@gmail.com. Whoever gives the first correct answer will get one extra term work mark. In this case, we have image A, which is shown over here, and structuring element B. So image A, it's a binary image. So the background is black. And in that image, there are two white patches, both the white patches of the width 3D. And the height of both the patches is 5D. The gap between the two white patches is 2D. And around them, you can say there is a background of width or height 3D. Okay, so that is the image A. Whereas the structuring element B has a width D and height 2D. And it is a rectangular image or structuring element with the center marked as shown in the figure. So what you need to do? You need to perform three recursions of operations of dilation, erosion, opening and closing. And whatever the resulted image, you have to show me the final result. Okay. So it is simply A dilated with B, whatever result dilated again with B, and then whatever result again dilated with B. Okay. So this is three recursions of dilation. Similarly, one can perform three recursions of erosion, three recursions of opening and three recursions of closing. Okay, so you have to draw the final figures and mail it to me. Thank you.